In today's video, we will learn what is cohort study, its fundamentals, design for cohort study, types, Framingham cohort study, example of cohort study, potential biases in cohort studies. Cohort study is a study of a group of people who have something in common, for example, a characteristic or risk factor for disease. Fundamentals of cohort study. Cohorts are selected for cohort study on the basis of exposure status. Outcomes of cohort study are incidence of disease in exposed and unexposed groups. Measure of association for cohort study is relative risk. Cohort study is conducted when exposure for disease is rare. Direction of cohort study is from exposure to outcome. Design for cohort study is shown in this slide, in which the population is divided into exposed and non-exposed groups. Then we follow up both groups. In exposed groups, some participants develop diseases, and some do not develop diseases. Similarly, in the non-exposed group, some participants develop disease and some don't. First, identify the exposed and unexposed population, and follow to see whether the disease develops or not. Calculate and compare incidence of disease in exposed group and unexposed group. And the relative of risk is calculated by this formula: incidence of disease in exposed group divided by incidence of disease in unexposed group. If we put the data in the above table, we will get smokers and non-smokers, and follow to see whether the coronary heart disease occur or not. The incidence of disease in smokers and non-smokers is calculated. The relative risk is calculated by the formula, which is 1.38. So it's clear that compared to non-smokers, the smokers have a 1.38 times greater risk of developing coronary heart disease. Types of cohort study. Prospective cohort studies is also known as concurrent or longitudinal study, in which the investigator assembles the study groups or cohorts in the present time, collects baseline data on the basis of exposure, and then continues to collect data for a period of time that can last from hours to years. Investigator starts the study from the beginning with the identification of the population on the basis of exposure status, and then follows them over time for the development of disease. Advantages of prospective cohort studies. Establishing temporal relationship between exposure and disease. Allows for measurement of incidence. Study of multiple effects of a single exposure. Disadvantages of prospective cohort studies. Time-consuming study takes a relatively long time to complete. Diseases that develop over a long period of time, or with conditions that occur as a result of long-standing exposure, many years are needed and hence high costs. Long wait until results are obtained, loss to follow-up. Cohort studies are problematic when disease or outcome is rare. For example, studying the risk factors clinical features associated with carcinoid tumors. Retrospective cohort study is also known as non-concurrent or historical study, in which the investigator goes back into the history to define exposure. For example, children exposed to X-rays in utero versus those do not, and then follows the cohorts up to the present to see what outcome have occurred. Investigator uses existing data collected in the past to identify the population and the exposure status. Determines the present status of disease. Investigator spends a relatively short time to assemble study population from past data, determine disease status at the present time. Advantages of retrospective cohort study. Less expensive compared to prospective cohort study. Completed in much shorter time than a prospective cohort study. Disadvantages: the quality of data collection is not as good as records generated for clinical purposes and not for research. Because of a large number of biases associated with these studies, carry less weight in establishing a cause than prospective studies. Prospective and retrospective cohort study, or combined cohort study, in which investigator uses existing data collected in the past to identify the population. Exposed or not exposed cohorts. Follow them into the future for the development of the disease. Investigator spends a relatively short time to assemble study population from past data, will spend additional time following them into the future for the development of disease. Example of cohort study. Framingham cohort study. Framingham is a town in Massachusetts, about 20 miles from Boston. Residents were considered eligible if they were between 30 to 62 years of age, a sample size of about 5,000 men and women. The study started with a defined population. Investigators started by identifying a new population and did not use existing data to identify the population and the exposure groups. There were several hypotheses to be tested, different exposures and different outcomes. For each exposure, investigators identified the exposed and the not exposed groups. For each exposure, the participants were followed for the development of disease. Different exposures were studied, as well as different diseases. Many exposures were defined, such as smoking, obesity, elevated blood pressure, elevated cholesterol levels, low level of physical activity, etc. New coronary events identified by examining the population every 2 years and by daily surveillance of hospitalization. Risk factors and the development of cardiovascular events were evaluated every 2 years by medical history, medical record review, and physical examination. All diagnoses were verified without knowledge of risk factors by Framingham examiners who reviewed medical records and death certificates. Approximately 3% of the subjects were lost to follow-up for mortality during the first 45 years of the study. Objectives of Framingham study: to study the impact of several factors on incidence of cardiovascular diseases. Exposures of Framingham study: blood pressure, smoking, body weight, diabetes, exercise, etc. Multiple outcomes of Framingham study: coronary heart disease, stroke, congestive heart failure, peripheral arterial disease. Milestones from the Framingham study: 1948, the start of the Framingham heart study. 1960s, cigarette smoking found to increase risk of heart diseases. 1961, cholesterol, blood pressure, ECG abnormalities found to increase risk of heart diseases. 1965's, first Framingham heart study report on stroke. 1967, physical activity found to reduce risk of heart disease and obesity to increase the risk. 1970s, high blood pressure found to increase the risk of stroke. 1974, diabetes found to be associated with cardiovascular disease. Potential biases in cohort studies. Selection bias: select participants into exposed and not exposed groups based on some characteristics that may affect the outcome. Information bias: collect different quality and extent of information from exposed and not exposed groups. Loss to follow-up differs between exposed and not exposed. Misclassification bias: misclassify exposure status or disease status. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.